we're just hanging out, walking around right now. And yeah. So I'm gonna take you with us.
She's in the flowers. I don't know what's with her and plants, but
that's a little Paris. It's a really good coffee shop.
I want to jump in there. I'm like, how are you going? No! No!
Leave it. There's a dog there, so
leave it.
Minty's a little bit in trouble. Come on, leave it.
Leave it.
Come on.
Leave it. Walk you.
That's Genetti's.
Walk.
It's dinner theater.
Now, oh, don't stop.
Hi.
she's not walking past us. If she catches me off guard and I'm not prepared for it, that's when she's going to back me up. When I know it's going to happen and I'm prepared for it, then she'll behave. You know, because I know because I'm prepared for it, and she'll listen to her dog, and I'm like, of course you do.
That's where we're going to lunch. We are now headed into Bricks for Kate's birthday. Get out of the bushes. We are now headed into Bricks for Kate's birthday lunch. So here we go. Hi, we have three of us. You talking to the German Shepherd?
I have a German Shepherd. Thanks.
Oh wait, I guess we go this way.
Follow, left, follow.
Of course we're shopping with my sister, but
the
babe.
Crab cakes.
Oh, I would have went and punched him in the face. I'm like, how do you like it? You don't punch your dog.
We learned how to make these really cool bracelets. And my mom wanted to start making them for people, like letting people buy them. Because everybody's like, oh my god, that's such a cool bracelet.
Yeah.
Well, so my mom bought all these, like, Schwartzky crystals and palm wheel seed beads.
Oh my goodness. So she's got a mountain of beads.
So we've got a mountain of that stuff that's never been used.
She should do it and sell them on Etsy. She can handmake them and sell them on Etsy.
I looked at that.
Oh, you did?
First of all, it takes me 3 hours to make one of these thick bracelets.
Wow. Oh.
It takes 3 hours?
3 hours. Or more. I think it took me more the first time I did it, but... Because you're not just threading beads, you're sewing beads together to make this damn bracelet.
So you've
got to
make sure
you've got the right number of seed beads on there and the right size crystal. And
then if you get a bunch of orders, you're going to be sitting there all day.
Yeah.
And your hands are going to fall off.
Yeah, really. You know, if I don't lose a needle first.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I've done that. Mm-hmm.
And they can't do shit because you're stepping on their leash right there.
She will try. Yeah, I'm talking about you.
Okay, guys, we are home. And it was a fun day. I'm sure you could tell a lot of the stores down there were like cutesy little boutiques. So I just bought a few things and I thought I would show you some of the things. Trying to do this with one hand. Okay, so this first thing is a pair of shoes. I've been looking for a pair of flats since probably last fall that I actually really liked and I could go walking in and had padding and weren't like cheap flimsy piece of shoes. The cute little boutique I got them at, the owner is super nice, very dog friendly, and this is their bag. It is called Lorla, L-O-R-L-A, and I got, well, first off, it's upside down, so I got these Blowfish shoes, which look like this. They're super comfortable. And they have like the memory foam padding in them. And then the grips on the bottom. So I bought that from that store. And then this other store was the one I showed you guys a lot of. I'm gonna sit down. It was the Dancing Eye store, which is a lot of individual artists who come together and put their stuff in a boutique. So, one of the first things I will show you. Maybe I should have taken everything out of the packaging, but didn't think that far ahead. This is their bag. And I got a shirt. One second. I got a shirt which says, it's called Pop, Not Soda, and it's super soft and lightweight, and this is down there, and if it's too big, I wear it as a PJ top. The second thing is this cute little magnet. Again, they give you packaging for all of your stuff, and this is the cute magnet. And it's actually like a little tile. There's the artist's name. If you would like to Google them, you might find some of their work if you like this stuff. And then I only bought one more thing, which I don't know if I'm gonna keep this or give this as a gift. Oh, we went into a dog store and Bailey decided to help herself to one of these. So she got herself a beef stick. The last thing I got was in this box here. Again, hand stamp logo. One second. So this is the last item I bought. Had to bring it over here because the lighting over there was not good. It's kind of rusty, western looking cross. I will put the information below just in case. If you guys want to check out any of these artists, if you need more information that I did not disclose or you couldn't read or whatever on any of these tags, let me know. I hope you'll check some of them out. I hope you guys like some of this stuff. I think some of it's really cool. And I like supporting local artists and craftsmen, I guess. So that's what I got today. I think I'm gonna end the vlog here, but I hope you did enjoy today. So thanks for watching. Hit the thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And I will see you tomorrow. Bye.